Okay, good morning everyone. So we're gonna start a new chapter, and this is about limit. So on this chapter, I'm gonna teach you what's the definition of limit, what limit is, and then the properties of limits, and then the application of it, and the algebraic calculation of it. Okay, so this is the most basic foundation for you to learn calculus. If you don't understand about limit, that you won't understand about derivative and integral. So it's really important for you to really understand the basic concept of limit. Yeah. So now open your book, page 33. Open your book, page 33. So actually the objective of this first lesson is for you to understand what limit is. Yeah. Find the limit of fx as s approaches c if fc is undefined. So today, from this lesson, I'm going to teach you about the basic concept of limit. And how we are going to do that is by going through the exploratory problem set 2.1 from number 1. I hope you can understand and follow. Okay. Now, figure 2.1 shows the function fx equals to x squared minus 5x plus 2 over x minus 2. And the graph is given. So on my iPad, on my screen, I also already shared to you about the fx equation and the graph of the function. And then let's go through it. Show that f2 takes the indeterminate form 0 over 0. So 0 over 0 is called indeterminate form, and I will explain to you the definition of indeterminate form later. Yeah. So when x, equals 2, okay, so basically the fx will be, f of 2 will be equal to 8 minus 10 plus 2 over 2 minus 2. Okay, which will be 0 over 0. Yeah, so it will be 0 over 0, and it's proven that actually f of 2 is indeterminate form, 0 over 0. Explain why there is no value for f of 2. Of course, there is no value, because if you have a number divided by 0, then you know that it's gonna be called undefined, right? It means that there is no value that can define f of 2 in this case. Yeah. Now let's go to b. Now this is really important for you to understand about limit. The number y equals 3 is the limit of fx as x approaches 2. The number y equals 3 here. Y equals 3 here. This one, yeah, is the limit of fx as x approaches 2. Make a table of values of fx from each 0.001 unit from x from 1.007 to 2.003. Is it true that fx stays close to 3 when x is kept close to 2 but not equal to 2? Now I have made the table for you here. So this is the table. Is it big enough? Can you see it? I hope you can see it. So when x equals 1.997, then y is equal to 2.994. 1.998, 2.996. 1.999, 2.998. And then when x equals 2, of course, it's undefined. Okay? And then when x equals 2.001, it's 3.002, 2.002, 3.004, 2.003, and 3.006. So be aware that when x equals 2, the value of the function is undefined. That's for sure. That you need to keep in mind, that the exact value, one more time, the exact value of the function when x equals 2 is undefined because of this calculation. Okay. But when x is not equal to 2, but it's really close to 2, for example, 1.999 and 1.998 and 1.997 and 2.001 and 2.002 and 2.003, apparently the value of the function is really close to 3. Right? The value of the function is really close to 3. Therefore, actually, by that fact, we can say that the limit, I will write it for you, the limit of fx as x approaches 2 in this case is equal to 3. Why? Because when you see that when the x is increasing little by little, when the x is increasing little by little by 0.001 unit into 2, the value of the function is also approaching 3. The x is approaching 2. The y is... The y is approaching 3. Okay. Also, from the other side, when the x is approaching 2 from the value that is bigger than 2, x is approaching 2, then again the same number is approached by the value of the function, which is y approaching 3 also. Okay? That's why the limit of fx as x approaches 2 is equal to 3. Now I'll stop there and I will read you the verbal definition of a limit. It's from your book above the objective. L is the limit of fx. In this case, 3 is the limit of fx. As x approaches c, in this case, as x approaches 2, if and only if you can keep fx arbitrarily close to L by keeping x close enough to c, but not equal to c. So in this case, why is 3 the limit? Because when the x is approaches 2, but not equal to 2, when x approaches 2, but not equal to 2, then actually the value of the function is actually approaching 3, right? The value of the L is really close to 3. You can see 2.996, 2.998, 3.002, 3.004. So therefore, we can say that the limit of fx as x approaches 2 in this case is equal to 3. Okay? Okay. So, yeah. That's basically the theory of a limit. That's basically the basic foundation, the basic concept of a limit. You need to understand that one more time, I will read the verbal definition to you. L is the limit of fx as x approaches c, if and only if you can keep fx arbitrarily close to L by keeping x close enough to c, but not equal to c. The key is the x must be close enough to c. Because if we make it x equals to c, then actually the fx will be undefined. But if the x is close enough to c, then we will say that that's the limit of the fx. And the value x is, in this case, x equals 3. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you.